Hello, MechWarriors! How is it going? Welcome to your daily dose of MechWarrior Online. Today, we are playing the Stormcrow because I wanted to see how much Alpha Strike I can pack in a Stormcrow in a kind of a viable build. And we are going for 101. We are going for 101 here because why not? So the build consists of 3 SRM-6 with Artemis and then just 10 heavy small lasers. 10 heavy smalls just straight away. We've got 5 in the right arm. We have 4 in the left arm and 1 in the center or in the head here. And yeah, that's it. We also have a bunch of heat sinks. We have a targeting computer Mark 1 and an active probe here because I had some spare weight. And honestly, I didn't really know what to do with that. But then I found out that actually it's a good idea to take the targeting computer and the Beagle active probe because both of them provide a targeting time boost bonus, which means that your playstyle is you just hide behind cover, you figure out where the enemies are, you just dash out, quickly get a lock on them, see where they are vulnerable, and shoot everything in there, and then they die. This is just it. Therefore, targeting time boost is really, really nice. By the way, guys, the thing about targeting computer, there is a little misconception. Targeting time means that you get a faster information on the enemy status and their loadout, not a faster lock for missiles. This is very important. So again, there's a misconception in the heads of some people, and I hope I could get rid of that. So targeting time is only the time that you get the information on your mech when you hit the R button, not your lock on time when you try to focus with the reticle for getting ATMs or LRMs locked. So targeting computer doesn't do that much for LRMs. The skills. Let me take a look at the skills here. We have invested a little bit into firepower. I was skipping cooldown here. Guys, we don't need cooldown that much because we're gonna get hot anyway, and we need some time to cool the mech down in terms of heat. So therefore, this is not a DPS build where you constantly fire and need a high or low cooldown of the weapons. This is a big Alpha Strike burst build, and therefore we were skipping cooldown and we were going for more heat and of course the laser duration and the missile nodes here. And yeah, you can skip to cooldown. That's what I want to say here. I have a lot of survivability, or a little bit of survivability here. And I went down this path here to the cluster down below because I think this is the best that you can get for the amount of points when it comes down to raw HP. I want to be, this is a very short range build, I want to be on the front line, and therefore we need some survivability. And I was going down with the armor path first, but you get more HP if you go down here because you can get some skeletal density on the way and use the armor nodes down below here. Therefore, this cluster down there. We skip mobility. You could argue that speed tweak is nice to have or even needed because you want to close distances, but if you are just patient and hide and then ambush the enemies, then you don't really need that. The Stormcrow is relatively speedy. It runs 97 kph, and therefore I'm skipping speed tweak here. We have no jump jets, of course, but we have the operation trees filled out with the cool run nodes, and I'm going for hill climb here. It's kind of a no-brainer. We have the radar deprivation, and we have double cool shot because the build itself, it is relatively toasty. Heat management 1.05. That's basically nothing, but it runs okay. So again, you want to go in when you have a CQ kill, and then you get that, and then you get down to cover again and cool down, and that's it. That's the build, everybody. I wish you all a lot of fun in the 2 games that are coming, and if you have that, as always, don't forget to leave a rating or subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And now it's time to hit the battlefield. Alright, first game of the day. We are playing the Grim Plexus, we are playing Domination, and I'm looking forward to it. Look at that. This is so cool. And it's actually pretty manageable. So we got heavy lasers. And if we can't get into range, we got SRMs. And if we fire everything together, we have crazy Alpha Strike. I just did a testing run in the testing grounds, and the Atlas doesn't stand a chance. So let's see what we can do here, right? Override engaged. I want to get to the circle. If the circle gets denied by the enemy, if they have light mechs coming over, I am ready. I am so damn ready. They have the circle. Let's check the buildings in Fox 7. Raven, come with me, please. There's something coming in. Okay, ready to shoot? Not quite. Not quite. Okay, we got him. Nice kill, thank you.
GG.
New target. Okay, bring up a UAV, prepare your missiles, guys.
UAV. Right. What's a rank blank gold 7?
Ooh. Okay, that locust got killed.
Can you come with the Centurion?
Big time. I should have shot the lasers first, God, guys. I was. Ooh, wait. Urban mech. Urban mech close. Urban mech super close. Ooh, careful. Sorry, guys. You don't like that, right? And that's it. Deleted. Let's get back, guys. Oh my God. Oh crap! I mean, it is super risky doing that, but it's so good. The close range annihilate. I want to get Irby. Let's get Irby, guys. Let's get it. Oh, sorry. I feel bad. I feel so bad for the Irby. Oh my god. Ah, the Atlas laser show here. All right, let's try again. Wait. I need the king crab. I want it so bad. Give me the king crab. Please give it to me. Ah, yeah, left side. Let's go. Is he coming? No? Okay. Right side? Oh, there's another guy. Ah, damn it. Couldn't bring the damage to the point. guys, keep up the push. We have 3 kills. We can definitely kill them. And yes, I'm saying that because I want to get in the fight and I do not want to wait any longer. Okay. Now this guy. Alright. Okay, let's get back. I'm the one on the front line. I don't like to be here. No, don't block me. Sorry. It was my fault. Getting in there and then pulling back. Yes. I called a push. That was a minute ago though. But still. Let's walk with the Atlas. I think the Atlas is a good meat shield. So yeah, my status is relatively critical. But we definitely pulled our weight here. Okay, Atlas is going in. There we go. Oh no! Alright, let's go for the Timby. Alright. This guy. No, he destroyed my arm. But you know what? It's fine. Again, I did my stuff here. I definitely did my stuff. Oh god, this build. This is devastating. Can we? No? Am I down? I am more or less down. SRM ammo depleted. Okay, we got the Warhawk, which is a one-shot. Come on, dude. There we go. And I'm still alive. I'm in one touch, but hey, I'm still alive. Let's challenge this guy. No? Okay. Yeah, I'm missing a lot of my firepower. God, this game. That was a lot of mechs obliterated here. Cool. Yeah, my team is just cleaning up and then that's it. Wow. Yeah, this is a build which can give you a significant advantage early on. So if you get a quick kill on an enemy light or medium or whatever, maybe 2, because you have enough sustain, maybe 3, then you just establish such a great advantage for the team that the enemy cannot possibly come back. Possibly. But yeah, we got 3 kills with 6 assists, 3 KMDD. It was just quick work here. We had 664 damage with 4 components, and that's the first round. Let's go over to the next one and see how this will go down. Alright, second game of the day. We are playing the Forest Colony and we are playing Skirmish, and I quickly want to check out the canyon. There is a slight chance, actually there's a relatively high chance that they are coming from the Gulf 8 area on Skirmish this year. And I want to see if they just throw in some scouts to scout out the area, and maybe I can spot somebody here and maybe I can get a quick kill on a light mech. It's a lot of maybes, I know, but we gotta figure that out. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna poke around the side here. I wanna quickly check. Just wanna give my team some intel here, so I'm basically our scout right now. Yep, there they are. Okay, I have a Mad Cat here, but they are going to the hotel line, guys. Hotel line is gonna be hot. Just go ahead and defend there. Gulf 8 is clear. Okay. So, yeah, nobody's here. Don't go to Golf 8, guys. Hotel. So we want to set up here somewhere. Somewhere along those lines here. This is our ambush spot here. And then we wait. We're gonna be super, super patient. Hello, Irby. Hello. Hey. What? What up? There they come. Okay. Alrighty. So, yeah, we need more mechs here. People are still going to Golf 8. I don't know why. Seriously, hotel? This is, no. No, this is my spot, guys. I wanted to ambush. Now you are here. This is not how an ambush works. This is, no. This is not good cover. Just one person can stand here in this canyon. Not all of you. Okay. Atlas coming. Let's go. Our Atlas is somewhat pushing, guys. This maybe. Nah, it wasn't enough. Was out of range there. Yep. Out of range. Barely, but still out of range. Okay, this is better now. I am in a very comfortable spot. And why is it? Okay, never mind. I'm not asking. I'm not asking questions here. All right, we can do this. Oh, that's the Centurion from before. Hello, Griff. Oh, the missiles. They have a UAV up in Hotel 8. Okay, the good thing is that we have a firing line here around that canyon. The bad thing is that I cannot contribute on a firing line. I am a skirmisher. I cannot really stand and shoot. It's not what I do. I want to get intimate. I want to get in and then fight with my knives here, my heavy laser knives. But yeah, I just wait for my team to do their stuff. We will get into the fight eventually, so I'm not even worried. And if we can get in late, then we can snatch up some kills here. I recently learned a new term. It is not kill stealing, it is kill borrowing. Right? Kill borrowing. Okay, this Centurion needs to die. Let's try to do it. Never mind, this guy. Sorry for pushing in front of you. But I wanted that guy. Can we? Come on. Yeah. It was worth it. I got a lot of damage here, I know, but I think it was worth it. Oh, this is not a good spot for me. Oh, yeah. This is so... I don't like peeking with that mech. You really, really need mobility. And if you take that away from the mech, from this loadout here, then it doesn't work. It just doesn't work. That's the sad thing about it. Oh, crap. I shouldn't have done that. I regret my decisions. Can we push around right side, guys? We need to do something here. I have a feeling that the stand and shoot thing doesn't work out. Or maybe it does, but my Cyclops is finally going in, so let's go! This is the moment I was waiting for. Let's go for the Mauler. Hi! Get wrecked. Woo! And now we push through. We are behind them. Okay, we got that going for us. Now we dodge down here. My team is following up, and I break line of sight, so, yeah, looking good. Wait, are you following me? Don't. Okay, I got the kill, but I killed myself. Yeah, it was a do or die situation. I could have just killed him, or he would have killed me with his friend, so I went for the kill. I think it was the better choice. So we traded one-on-one here, but yeah, in the end it was good. And this is again, this is the drawback. So this is the build how it plays when you are in a firing line. And I just wanted to show you guys, you need the mobility to make things work. If you get that, fine, you are super, super fine just wrecking left and right. But in a static firing line situation, you cannot reliably peek because of the high laser duration. And you need to stagger your shots. That means that you have the high laser duration twice to deal all of the damage, which means you have a lot of face time. And usually you mitigate that face time by just being mobile and dodging the shots. But if the enemy just sees you standing in front of them, just trying to get the laser some point, it is not good. But yeah, so just keep that in mind. I'm just going to upload this game here just as a reminder or as a you know, as the other side of the coin, of the medal. It is super high damage, super high risk and high reward, but if you end up in a firing line, try to make something happen, try to call for a push or something. Yeah, anyway, we had 3 killing blows nonetheless. Okay, we got 4 KMDD. How? How did we get 4? All right, I guess we got 4k MDD. And then 451 damage done. Again, the build is not about massive damage numbers. It is about quick kills, right? Keep that in mind. Don't farm damage with that. And we got 5 components destroyed. Yeah, that is your daily dose for today, everybody. That is the Stormcrow with the super high close range Alpha Strike build. I like it. I'm going to play it a little bit more on the streams. If you haven't already, follow me on Twitch. Link is down below in the description. Also, there's the link to my Patreon page. If you want to support the channel, go there. You can get some nice rewards for that. So I got some perks, for example, monthly postcards, and yeah, I hope to see you on the battlefield. Goodbye.